everybody. Happy final build session. Are we awake? Oh my goodness, thank you. I was worried. I know day three is always the day that everyone's like, I could stay in bed a little bit longer. So thank you all for coming out and hanging out with us. We have an amazing session today, all things client and mobile application development with .NET MAUI. Usually what I do in this talk is I stand up here and I tell you what .NET MAUI is. We are doing something a little bit different. We have invited a very special guest, Rod Ball, the CTO of Earth Solutions. They have been using MAUI to modernize their mobile apps. Thank you. Round of applause. they've been using MAUI to modernize their app. They have a case study coming out with all of the Microsoft stack they're using in a couple of weeks. But we thought you could come up here and tell us a little bit about what your app does and why you chose MAUI.
Yeah, thanks, Maddy. Our application allows field workers to see the work that's been assigned to them. It makes it easy for them to prioritize their work based on risk and when it is due, enabling them to make their work done on time as well as do it efficiently. Our app today was first released in 2015. Today we have thousands of users and hundreds of companies using our application. Our app is built using Xamarin and WPF for the desktop app. It was time to modernize our application, so we wanted to unify the code base and share more code. So .NET MAUI checked all the boxes for the requirements of our application. In the video you see playing right now behind me, you'll see our home screen, navigating to our summary screen, which displays the list of items that have been assigned to the user, as well as the locations of the items on the map, and then navigating to the details to get more information about them.
Cool. And taking pictures is my favorite part. You were a very early adopter of MAUI. I think you guys were some of the first customers trying to get this into production. And MAUI GA'd at build last year. Happy birthday, us. Thank you. So what have you seen from MAUI from when you started until now?
Yeah, we started using .NET MAUI early last year, in April of last year, well before it was released to GA. Since then, we've seen consistent improvement in the features, as well as regular rollouts for fixes for issues.
Cool. So tell us a little bit about the features of this app and how you're actually building them. What packages and things you're using?
Sure. We're using Visual Studio on both Windows and Mac to build our apps. We're using Esri's ArcGIS Map SDK for mapping. We're using Telerik for some controls. We're using Browser Stack for both automated and manual testing. And then we're using Azure as our backend for its reliability, scalability, and security.
Cool, awesome. So let's actually look at some code. You generously gave us this screenshot. We did not want to walk through your code base. That seems like a bad idea to do live. But we zoom this in. Tell us a little bit about what's going on with this MAUI app here.
Sure. One of the things we really love about .NET MAUI is being able to allow to do development on all the platforms in one location. It really has helped simplify our dev process. We target iOS, Android, and Windows.
Cool. And one of the great things that people familiar with MAUI know about is our single project structure. So it seems like you're taking good advantage of it.
Yeah, we have lots of libraries, screens, and models. So only having to manage them in one project makes it a lot easier. We have 83 views and counting in our app.
Wow, that's a lot. That's a lot of views.
Even more, we are taking advantage of the fonts, images, raw assets, and styling. Again, all from one place, which saves us loads of time. We do some platform-specific things, so we decided to put those in the platform folders to make it easier to find.
Awesome. And so what's coming next? I'm sure you're not done with feature work.
Next up, we'll be implementing dynamic forms rendering using Blazor Hybrid. We will need to generate hundreds of forms on the fly that are designed by our business users using our web application, and then render them in a Blazor web view. This will be a huge improvement over downloading HTML and JavaScripts and rendering them in a web view as we do today.
Cool. And so where are we in the process of actually production and publishing these apps?
Yes, the apps are available in the store today. We're currently in the process of working with customers to roll these out to the field users. We've had extremely positive feedback so far, and the field users are pumped.
Cool, awesome. If there was one thing you were going to say to a room full of potential or existing .NET MAUI developers, what would it be?
Yeah, we really find that the new handler architecture, it makes it easy for us to implement workarounds in our .NET MAUI layouts.
Yeah, very cool. Great. Well, that's Rod, everybody. Thank you for joining
us. Thank you.
And again, keep an eye on out for the Earth Solutions case study. We think it should be out in about 2 weeks. .net/customers is where you can see all that great stuff. Before we get into the rest of the content, we have half of the MAUI PM team over here. Say hi to Beth and Becky, everybody. They are running and moderating Pubble. So if you scan that QR code, they are going to be popping up polls throughout the session just for fun. You don't have to do them, but if you're interested, good way to give some feedback as we roll. You can also send questions to them. My counterpart, who will come up here in a minute, added a bunch of slides last minute, so I don't think we'll have time for Q&A at the end, but we will definitely hang out in the hallway after as well, and we can keep note of what you ask in Pubble. So hopefully what you just learned from that amazing case study is kind of what MAUI is. It's a single project, single architecture, .NET for mobile and desktop, and hybrid. So Blazor Hybrid is a really great way to leverage your existing web skills, but bring your .NET to the desktop, to the mobile phone. We kind of think of the Blazor stack as reach, right? Web is everywhere, it's kind of ubiquitous. But we have MAUI as the depth if you need native, if you need an actual real native experience to build for your users, whether that's offline functionality, integrating with something like the taskbar, all of those things. So we, you know, you could take a little of this, a little bit of that, peanut butter and jelly, put them together, and that's Blazor Hybrid. We're not going to talk too much about Blazor Hybrid for the rest of this session. There was a lot of that this week, so definitely check out the on-demand stuff if you missed it. But we're going to talk more about MAUI. And now I'd like to invite up my colleague slash partner in crime, Dave, product manager on the MAUI team, to talk a bit about where we have gone in the past year of being a product, which is exciting. Hi, Dave.
Hi, Maddy.
It's been great to see everybody this week. I'm glad you made the trek out to Seattle to see us in this beautiful new building. This has been really good. Thanks again to Rod for coming up and making the trip. That was kind of like a woohoo, you can get somebody up here and talk about it. I felt like his story really would resonate with everybody here because it, like you said, ticks a lot of the boxes of what MAUI's value proposition is. And as you can see, we've got so many more customers that you should recognize several, if not many, of these logos up here. They are, of course, just the tip of the iceberg in terms of what we have seen from customers using .NET MAUI. And they're not all just Xamarin upgrades. There are some new development as well. So as we are able to share more case studies, we will certainly be sharing that out. They will end up on the .NET website.
Yep.
What was the other thing I was going to mention about this? There was something good.
All things are great.
Oh, hundreds of apps in the app stores. Increasing all the time. I think the last count that we got was like from early January.
Yeah.
And we know that if you've been using MAUI, it's getting easier and easier to use, and so we're super excited to see them published to the store.
And if you want your logo on this slide, let us know.
And if you do, yes, let us know. So what's actually happening? What are we tracking? So we do track engagement in terms of like how often are you using .NET MAUI across all the Visual Studio tools, as well as just the command line usage. And the growth has been awesome. So 636% since May of last year. And that number probably is a little outdated. It's probably even a little bit more by today. And I'm, in addition, probably even more excited about the next number over there, that MAUI is the most active .NET Foundation project. So these numbers were from, I believe, March, April timeframe. And essentially, if you just look at the issues, the pull requests, the contributors, you're going to find that the things that make up .NET MAUI, the Android, the iOS, the runtime stuff, it is the most active, which is awesome. So thank you. To all of our contributors, if you are a contributor in the room, would you stand up?
If you maintain any packages, libraries,
maintain a
things
package.
That people use, Morton.
You write code? Ties and teams right
Ties
there.
And
you
teams
guys
here.
Can
you
stand
guys stand up.
Yeah, yeah. We've got some contributors there. Give them a hand.
Thank you. Wow, everyone's tired.
Everyone's tired.
That's okay.
Well, you've been drinking from the fire hose this week, a lot of information. You've been drinking it up into the late hours of the evening.
Yeah.
So there's a couple of chuckles. There's a couple of chuckles. It wasn't the best joke of the day. Maddy, tell us about what's been happening with .NET 7 and Visual Studio.
Well, things are fast, so that's cool. We like speed. We like things to be faster, and we like things to be smaller. And those were two of the key numbers we looked at when .NET 7 went out, we wanted to see how fast your app loaded up, how fast pages rendered and drew themselves on the screen, and then how big your app actually was. So these are all things we measure all the time. We'll talk a bit about .NET 8 later, but you know, this is something we're always measuring, and we make sure the numbers are always going in the correct direction with every release. We try not to let them go the wrong direction. That's the goal. And it's not just in the SDK. We've done a bunch of work inside of Visual Studio to make just things faster, more stable, a little bit less janky, we like to say, less jank. So just in general, folks using Pear to Mac have probably already noticed our success rate has like gone up over 30%, which is amazing. And I think two Visual Studio releases, mm-hmm. which is pretty good. First launch success, first build success, those things are all up. So we take a lot of time making sure our getting started story is really smooth so that when you have new developers join your team and get started with MAUI, they have a good experience. What's going on with desktop?
Yeah, so let's cover a little bit of what we have been doing or what we have already shipped in .NET 7. If you're not already familiar with some of these things, this will be new to you, but let's recap real quick so that everybody's up to speed. So in .NET 7, we did a very short six months after we shipped .NET 6 at build last year. So of course, there really wasn't a whole lot of time to jam a bunch of features in there. But a few things did get put in, such as tooltips. And most of these things are desktop focused, as Maddy just mentioned. So we had a few more gaps there as compared to mobile, which has been around, of course, for much longer. So you can just annotate with an attached property. If you didn't know, when you do something like tooltip properties.txt on top of a button or anything else, it's called an attached property. Everybody knew that, right? Everybody knew that? Nobody knew that?
Yeah.
I can actually see you. You can raise your hands.
All right, he knew it. That's good.
Pointer hovers. So you need to be able to mouse over something and see it change. Of course, from a UX perspective, that's super important. If you don't see that color change or you don't see your cursor change, you're going to be like, is it interactive? Is it not interactive? I don't know. It's, of course, not something that you typically deal with on a mobile phone, unless you've tried hovering over your phone with your finger to see what happens.
That's the next iPhone, didn't you hear?
It works on my car.
Really?
Yeah, I can get really close to it. Anybody else? Your car? No? All right, so pointer hovers, very cool. Context menus, you can right-click on things now. Right-click in and of itself is also a new thing. Of course, it's called a secondary click. What?
You weren't on the slide.
I wasn't on the slide?
No.
Well, I was getting there.
Okay.
You see what I'm dealing with up here?
We're getting there, all right? Keep on track. We have 30 minutes left.
I added more slides. You heard that part, right?
Yes, this morning.
All right, so right-click, a lot more things like that you can do. And what's also been very exciting this past period of time is seeing many of our existing and some new component vendors come online with controls that you can use. So I know that SyncFusion has been around this week. I think Grape City was also around. I saw Grape City t-shirts. I didn't actually figure out where their booth was.
Yeah.
But that's awesome. So I wanted to give you a few highlights. I reached out to them recently and said, hey, how's it been going? But also, you know, give me some highlights. What's new? So I've got some news for you. So DevExpress has been using .NET MAUI since before we GA'd and building controls. They're all free. Who likes free? Thank you. They're raising their hands.
There
now.
We go. They're getting that.
I just had to say free.
All I had to do was move a slide free. For you.
Yeah.
It caused some trouble. We're good.
You just had to jump in and take credit. Okay.
Yeah.
So some really sweet controls here. Beautiful stuff. Data grid, collection viewer, just to name a few. So check those out. Google the DevExpress or Bing it, or talk to Bing Chat and say, dear Bing Chat, what controls does DevExpress have? Has anybody ever had Bing Chat like reject your question?
Oh.
maybe I'm just asking pointed questions.
Yeah.
In addition to that, I was talking to the guys from UX Divers, and they have made some pretty interesting updates to GrileKit. I think we've all really loved seeing the GrileKit stuff. It looks great, but some of the pain points are you would have to go to their web portal, you'd have to pay for a one-app license, there really wasn't a free tier. And then it was kind of like it builds the solution, you download it, and then it's kind of hard to iterate on your app. Well, now they're shipping free templates. I said free. That's the part where you...
Free.
I thought that was the cue. They were just looking at every time I say free. Not only that, but they are now working on and are about to preview a extension for Visual Studio, whereby you can just go grab templates, grab individual controls, compose them as you want to, all while working in your solution, and then bring those in. So it's kind of like a generator built into Visual Studio. You don't have to go back to a website. You don't have to reload a whole solution or anything like that. And they have this really cool Grile Studio widget on the side for picking font icons. They've got a whole bunch of icons, some that they've made themselves, some from some popular fonts that you're familiar with. So check that out. Grab that bit.ly down there. Go sign up for that preview and check that out. Of course, Progress Telerik has been on board forever, and Sands of Maui, we love. You know, Sam Basu has always given us a beautiful roundup of all the Twitter news, the blogs, et cetera. Tons of controls, too many to name, so I just give you the list here. And some of the new stuff that they're working on is infusing some AI into their controls.
I haven't heard that word this week.
No, yeah. Did you just drink?
Oh, that's a good point. It's water, people.
So that's some cool stuff. Continue to follow that and check that out. Of course, I mentioned SyncFusion has been around. They have gorgeous controls. They use the MAUI graphics library to render a lot of this stuff. So you get some very beautiful things that render pixel by pixel perfect across all the platforms. Also, I know that they have a free tier. They also have project templates. And they have built-in type converters. Who doesn't love a bunch of type converters?
It's true.
Yes.
It's true.
Especially if you're a XAML developer. And kind of new to the game is Xceed. They're new to this. They have been around a long time with WPF. Anybody who used a WPF Xceed control in your applications? All right, I saw a few hands. Okay, cool. So check these out. If you've been looking for that button that you can throw any content you want to in it, they got that. I checked it out. It's really sweet, very easy to use, does what it says on the box.
Wow.
So link to their GitHub. It is on NuGet. And also, what's the keyword? Free.
Free.
Yay.
Yay.
So that's really exciting.
Yeah. I mean, we have a lot that's come out.
.NET 8
is coming in hot,
year.
Too, yeah. Which is very exciting.
I know.
The previews are out. We're on preview.
Preview 3 is shipped. I think preview 4 is coming. No, preview 4 is out, preview 5 is coming,
I don't know,
right?
There's a lot of them. We're somewhere in the middle between 1 and release candidate.
Yeah.
So definitely grab them. There's a lot going on. These are just some of the highlights. Obviously, stability, like we mentioned at the beginning, that's kind of our number one thing, making sure all of the numbers we can track are moving in the correct direction. That's important. We want the numbers to be green. Workloads, we are working on something called .NET Workload Clean, which if that means something to you, you're going to be very excited. If it doesn't, don't worry about it. We hope you never have to use it. But yeah, a better management of .NET workloads and also being able to pull MAUI nightly or pre-release builds in as NuGet packages straight from our GitHub. You don't have to do anything interesting there. Mm-hmm. Desktop, Dave will dive more into some more great navigation things we're doing and keyboard things we're doing. Of course, Blazor Hybrid. We have the new Hybrid Web View, which is not actually just Blazor Hybrid. It is Hybrid, where you can put React, Angular, plain old JavaScript, I don't know why you do that, right into a web view. Dave had a lightning demo of that yesterday that I believe will be uploaded at some point.
Yeah, there is already an on-demand, because I did a pre-record from home. You know, without the audience, I was actually on time.
Right.
Less jokes when you're just in the room by yourself. And actually, when I was putting together the demo for yesterday, I could not remember for the life of me how to write JavaScript. It has been a while. So I used Copilot.
Yeah.
Copilot bailed me out. It was fantastic.
It's pretty funny to watch, actually.
Yeah, she witnessed it.
I just stared at him typing for like 20 minutes at breakfast at a restaurant.
Well, I had a lot of information that I drank in the night before.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So the brain wasn't working quite so well, but Copilot seemed to be just fine, so.
Oh, wow, that's good. Wow.
Yeah.
And finally, native, always looking to make things in .NET more unified. Everything plays together nicely in the sandbox, I like to say. So native AOT as part of .NET. So if you have AOT apps existing, they're probably running on mono, different part of the .NET runtime. It's moved back into the home there. And also a lot of library just sharing. On here we have .NET to Objective-C and Swift. But we're also working on things to make that go the other direction, which I think you will talk about.
Do I? Yes, I do.
Yes, you do. You added that one this morning.
I did add that one this morning. Yeah, the native libraries thing, I'm sure that we'll have some blogs and it'll get documented eventually, but it's really cool. It's if anybody remembers the old Embedinator experiment from back in Xamarin days, yeah, you can take your .NET code and you can package it up as a native library and ship it to Objective-C, Swift, Java, Kotlin developers and have them use it. So be on the lookout for that if that's something that sounds interesting to you. And the native AOT is going to be available as an option.
Right, yeah, correct.
Okay, so in NET 8, so you can kind of opt into that and see if how that compares to the AOT that we have today. But so far, all indications from our benchmarks, faster and smaller, which is really, really
nice.
We
like to see.
Something that's, yeah, okay, so you mentioned at the top, and I wanted to kind of circle back to it because it's worth double-clicking on.
Oh, God. We're so close to the end.
We'll circle back, we'll double-click. Right?
Zoom in.
Zoom in on it. What are some others? Stability. NET 8 for us really is all about stability in our tooling and especially in the SDK. I was back and forth on another slide that I could add, but I'll just talk to it. So we're fully aware that you know there are gaps and there are a lot of issues that many of us run into. As Rod mentioned, you know they have used extensively the handler architecture to quickly work around things, which super happy that the architecture supports that, but that's not the goal, right? The goal is that you don't really ever need to use that until you want to. So knocking down the high impact issues is the main goal. Knocking down the number of issues is not the main goal. If we want to do that, we'll just close all the issues.
That's a good point, actually.
Right? That's how you burn down to zero.
I make a call.
That's how you burn down to zero. But what we do is we look at the number of reactions, the comments, who's commenting, what the actual severity of the issue is when we triage it, et cetera. And that gives us an impact score.
Right.
That impact score is unfortunately not something that's easy for us to surface visibly on GitHub. But we do have that in our internal tool that consumes GitHub. And then we prioritize those issues. You can see what those issues are by going to the GitHub repository and looking at our project board for the upcoming work. And as that work is completed, that which could be backported to NET 7 will be. However, the longer we get into NET 7, closer to NET 8, the likelihood of those things being backported, reduces.
Right.
So check out those NET 8 previews, please, as soon as you can. .NET new install MAUI. So let's talk a little bit about some of the features that are coming. There are a handful. So accelerators, as Maddy said, why is this called an accelerator? Probably some WPF reason.
Yeah, that's actually a good
right?
point.
somebody probably like Morton has a history that he can tell us all about this. He's not sitting where he used to. Morton,
no,
where'd
moved
you go?
Over, oh, so
you
we couldn't make jokes there. About him. It was smart.
Come on. I need to heckle the crowd. It's reverse heckling. So accelerators, what are they? They're shortcuts so that you can add them to any of your menu items. So if you want to trigger a menu item from a Control-S, Control-V, blah, 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 you can do that now. We have a pull request up for it. It is not yet merged, but you can track that and see that coming to a desktop near you. And this, okay, is what you mentioned before about going the other direction. So for the longest time, if you want to use any kind of a native library, a CocoaPod, some kind of framework, a Java library, et cetera, you would need to create a .NET binding for that, right? Who has created a .NET binding before to a native library?
A couple sorry okay. souls in the back there.
All right. Who would raise your hand and say, I absolutely love creating bindings. I would do it all day, every day of my life. Okay. For the record, nobody raised their hand. So what can we do to improve this? It's hard enough for us to do it. We know that it's a high bar for any of you to do it, any developers in general. Not at all a knock on your competence. You are awesome developers. But what can we do to make this easier? So we have this concept of a platform channel that we are iterating on, and it allows you to essentially bring that native library to your solution, but keep it in the native space. So yes, that means you would still have the Android tooling, you would still have the Xcode tooling, and you would use those, but how can we make it easier for you to interact from the .NET side and from the native side? So this is where platform channels comes in. So you can see here on the screen, I've got some Java code. This is a very basic example. I'm going to pass some text back and forth. And so I have this method where I'm going to handle methods from .NET, handle messages from .NET. And this is a method you would control, right? The channel is what we would provide. The methods that you want to create are in your control. You just make sure that they're accessible. And then on the .NET side, you instantiate your channel, you get or create that channel, and you call it. Here I'm obviously just passing some very simple things, some text and a method name, but you could imagine that you could send complex objects too, as long as the channel knows how to marshal those types and everything. So we think that this is going to really lower the bar for doing this. It's not the only concept we have to address this space, but I think that we would agree it's probably the most promising. Yeah. So there is a repository up on GitHub where we're starting this work, and then we'll move it into a more public place where you can check that out. And you know, I guess my request to you would be bring your libraries to us and say, hey, here's a library I need to be able to use. The binding is old. I need to replace it or do something with it. And we would love to use that as an example for us to build upon. Keyboard improvements. Who has ever had the keyboard pop up over your entry field and nobody can get to it? Yeah? Well, wouldn't you know, we've got a solution. It's called fixing the bugs.
Wow. That's good.
Yeah, you like that? You know, definitely, we know this has been a problem. So what you see on the first thing that you saw there was an epic fail from the original MAUI sample. Things are not exactly much better in the Xamarin Forum sample, but it is better. And then now we have the super-duper, nooper-duper cool MAUI sample.
Yeah, that works.
So TJ Lambert on the iOS team came over and helped out the MAUI team and spent several sprints working deep in the bowels of this. Both for iOS and for Android. Bowels? That made you giggle? Bowels? Oh, wow, we just went to a blank screen.
Oh, that's all right.
Doesn't matter. So look forward to that. Is there anything you need to do to implement this? You just need to update to the latest version of .NET MAUI once it ships and use it. Nothing that you would need to be able to do. I love the fact that it properly moves between the first name and the middle name, like the side-by-side stuff, as well as the vertical stuff.
Yeah, it's so nice.
Yeah, and there are ways for you to then more finely control your tabbing index and things like that using semantic properties. Some of that is in the community toolkit.
Yeah. All right, well, you know, this is 2023, and we have to talk about Copilot or we will get fired. No, I'm just kidding. We will not. We have mentioned
I didn't get that memo.
I know a lot of you are able to access now the Copilot chat from being a build attendee. It is really good. Admittedly, it does not do great with XAML, which is fine because I also don't do great with XAML. So we can be bad with XAML together. That's all good. But the C# stuff I've been using has been amazing. I mean, it's, you know, teaching Dave JavaScript in a Blazor hybrid app, which is pretty cool, which doesn't have any Blazor in it. Because I've been using it to make my view models not awful, because I'll be like, why isn't this showing up? And it will be like, you absolute dum-dum.
It does not.
This should be observable. And I'm like, oh my god, okay. But it's really cool. We've been liking it a lot and using it, and you can get the chat preview somehow.
So. Have we figured out how to tell Copilot to speak in the voice of Dan Roth?
Oh.
Yeah, wouldn't that be sweet? Who would use that?
I would use that.
Who would use that, right?
A very soothing, good voice.
Yes. Yeah. And you understand pretty much everything he says. He's very clear.
Yeah, I like that. So, yeah, GitHub Copilot in Visual Studio. GitHub Copilot chat, I believe, for Visual Studio 2022 is the extension name.
Okay.
Lots of words there.
We can get this today?
Yes, as a build attendee, there's some way for you to go magically get it.
Okay, some way magically get it. Does anybody know that magical way?
Yes. No, nobody does. Yeah. Okay, Google
one
it.
One person does? You know? Okay. It's your GitHub account handle linked to your registration email for build, and then things will start to work for you.
Yeah, you can add multiple GitHub emails.
He'll be standing outside the door after the session. Everybody can go talk to
him. Please bring your phone up like this. Can you help me, sir? I need Copilot. Yeah, so this is cool. It's been fun. What else is going on?
We alluded to the session about the hybrid web view, and you know, we with .NET 6, we shipped the Blazor web view, and has been very well received. We see really about a third of all new users coming to MAUI doing so with Blazor hybrid templates and using that functionality. And like I said, a lot of people that are using MAUI are actually not Xamarin upgrades. So we do see, you know, a significant amount of that as well, but a lot of the new stuff is happening in this space, which is cool. And so we talk to a lot of customers, of course, that's what we do, and developers in general. And when we show them the Blazor web view, there's many times where they say, that's awesome, but we actually don't use Blazor yet. We have a ton of Angular code, a ton of React code. Can we do the same thing or similar? And so that's where this comes from. Alon Lipton, who works on the MAUI team and for years and years and years, worked on ASP.NET, and I think at some point he might have been on the compiler team. Really?
Yeah, he's done it all.
He's been a long time. He's got a lot of crystals.
Yes.
You know, you get crystals at certain monumental points of your career. He took a lot of the foundational work that he had done with the Blazor WebView and then kind of enabled it for Angular and React. Unsurprisingly, as a developer with his experience in C# and .NET, he doesn't really have a lot of Angular and React experience. Nor do I. So who in here does? We're looking for you.
Couple. All right.
So
thank you for showing yourselves.
We want you to check this out, see how it might be useful to you, and you know, show us like, hey, in my React app, it would be great if we could kind of adopt some of these patterns. It would make it easier to integrate some of those things. So it's experimental for now. The idea being, of course, you can interact back and forth between the JavaScript. Many of us have probably already written a hybrid web view with some JavaScript bridging at one point or another, but this will be a more official, seamless way for you to do that. And of course, we will support it. But let us know. Check out that GitHub link, well, the aka.ms at the top there will take you to a GitHub,
right,
and you can provide us with information. It's currently on Alon's private repo. Don't let that freak you out. We will be moving things to a more public repo, along with some of the other experimental things that we have lurking around, like little thing that's a Linux backend and then a WPF backend. And is that interesting to anybody? Should we share that stuff on? Nobody cares. It's free.
There you go. You did your job.
Just had to throw free out there. All right.
Yeah.
All right, we got a few minutes left. Let's get into some tactical things here. So we do have official support policy. Some of that support is free. Some of it you can pay for.
Yeah, but there is free.
There is free.
It doesn't. Okay, thank you.
Sweet.
It's not the same effect when I say it. Mm. It's okay.
So we do ship, of course, with .NET. We are part of .NET, which is awesome. We have the confidence that we have the investment from all the powers that be that we can continue forward and support you and your endeavors. So when you're aligning roadmap, you want to look at something like this. We do ship every year, and then for 6 months after that, we support that release. So for example, .NET 6, we are now 6 months past the .NET 7 release. So it's actually no longer supported officially. and we will no longer be shipping service releases for .NET 6 MAUI. .NET 6 itself, the underlying SDK and runtime, of course, is still a long-term service supported release, and you'll be able to use that for the duration. But MAUI has dependencies, right? So we depend upon Xcode, we depend upon Android developer tools. So as those things ship, we need to make sure that we can ship rapidly on top of them. By the time that they go public in GA, you will always have bits from us that you can depend upon.
Right.
So that's important to know. The early betas, it does take us some time to create those bindings, and we will ship them as soon as we possibly can. But once RC1, RC2, Gold Master, or whatever they call it, ships, then you can get the bits. How do you get the bits? You can always get them off of our GitHub. off of our Azure pipelines. And then once we are able to hitch a train, hop a train, catch
yeah.
a train,
yeah.
Individual studio for that release cycle, then you will get it. So you may see those releases come perhaps a week or two after the release in Visual Studio, but that doesn't mean that the bits aren't available. You can always get them on GitHub.
Yep.
So what does this mean for, I already said that, Xamarin? Well, Xamarin is end of support May 1st, 2024. Why May? Why so soon? So May 1st, 2024 is the first day on which Apple will no longer accept updates to apps built with Xcode 14. And that is the version of iOS and Xcode that Xamarin uses. So we need everybody to upgrade to MAUI. You need to upgrade to MAUI. And so, of course, when I say MAUI, that's not just the cross-platform bits. If you have a Xamarin Android app or a Xamarin iOS app, upgrade.
Right.
We've seen tons of libraries in the community. I already showed the component vendors have released their stuff. We have done some work to provide compatibility packages for the likes of FFimage, which is a super popular library. Intune now has support for NET 6 and above for iOS and Android. App Center has released packages that are compatible, yep. including recently UI test for iOS and Android. So if you have a suite of UI tests in your Xamarin applications and you're like, I can't run them, now you can run them. So at least for your migration path, that is a good story for you to move forward. So we have more information on how you can get started with MAUI and upgrading your applications.
Thank you.
From my good coworker.
Matt. Yeah, everything, the link to the GitHub, the link to all the downloady stuff is .net/MAUI.
.net.
The easiest way, if you don't have MAUI already, just download Visual Studio and click off the box that says MAUI. It's got this purple thing with like four squares. It's supposed to be like the four platforms all coming together, symbolic or something. One of the things that we didn't get into in this talk, because we only had 45 minutes, and if you gave me and Dave all the time in the world, we would talk for 3 hours, is all of the tooling stuff that exists in Visual Studio, including the rapid UI iterating things we have. So the GIF or GIF. GIF up here, that's the poll. GIF or GIF?
No.
is of our someone hot reloading their app, editing their XAML, and using what we call the live preview to inspect their UI, see exactly like where it's being rendered with your actual data, you know, click on that and go to where in the source it's defined. Very cool things. If you're a Windows user, you can still develop iOS apps. Even if you don't have, you know, a Mac, you can just plug your iPhone in and do a lot of debugging that way. You still need a Mac to ship to the store, which is why we give you the Pair to Mac capability, so you can test it against actual, you know, all the different simulators and things that you get with Xcode. For those of you who are on Xamarin, and if Xamarin means nothing to you, good, good. That's really good. Welcome. It's a good time here. We don't need to give you the history lesson. If Xamarin does mean something to you, you can go check out the .NET Upgrade Assistant. It is an assistant. This is the thing we have to say every time. It will not magically upgrade your project.
Right.
Turns out all of you write code differently.
Shocking.
Who would have thought? Oh my goodness. So it's very hard to predict perfectly exactly what we should do to upgrade you 100% to MAUI. But Xamarin to MAUI is not a rewrite. All of the XAML, for the most part, stays the same. There's some things we obsoleted, some things we made better. It's really about replacing your NuGets with compatible versions, changing your project files, and then, of course, fixing your namespaces. So it says Microsoft.MAUI,
yes.
which is cool,
yes.
And some base types and stuff. We made an alias. There are four people on that alias, and they are in this room right now. And it is completely unmoderated. We have done no preparation for the influx of emails we started to get. That is my fault. It is maui-upgrades@microsoft.com. And what we're hoping for is that this is kind of your panic line or like, I did this thing and it worked. Oh my gosh, I want to tell someone. So send us your stories, trials, tribulations, packages that you're like, help. No one's maintaining this anymore. What's a good replacement? Look, I did this upgrade and it took me 5 minutes because you guys are amazing and I love you. And here's a Starbucks gift card. Actually, no, none of them like Starbucks, so that's okay. Only me. I'll take it. All of those things, send the email. Like I said, it's unmoderated, so there's a chance that we miss it. Feel free to ping it.
Yeah.
We're all going to be taking looks and keeping an eye on it and Just know that that is one of the many ways to get in touch with the .NET team. That was a good segue. I didn't even plan that. Oh, gosh. We're getting there. We're getting to the end. Thank you. Thank you so much. Follow .NET all over the place, even TikTok. And they now have charts that they report to us on the TikTok follower growth of the .NET TikTok, which is amazing. Yeah, lots of different ways. One thing that we added to the slide, too, is the .NET Discord. You can just join it. It's primarily for library and package maintainers. It's mostly so you can go in and ask the team like nitty-gritty architecture questions.
Yeah.
People are not really taking like bug reports or anything there. That's what GitHub is for.
Yeah, not bug reports, but let's say that you, for example, do run into something that's blocking your application and you don't see a fix coming and you're like, how do I work around this?
Yeah.
I hear about this handler architecture thing. How do I use that to address my issue? Come to Discord and engage with the engineering team. It is the core engineering team for MAUI that spends time in there. The Android and the iOS team are also there on occasion, and there's a whole bunch of channels. Avalonia and Uno, I believe, maybe even have channels in there.
Yeah.
So you can get a support and talk to people one-to-one, right? So use it. Again, you know, please be considerate. It's not where you file your issues. Those need to go to GitHub.
Right.
But if you're asking an architectural decision saying, hey, I'm trying to address this issue in my code base, how could I work around it? You're going to get good answers there. I mean, if you think that I know much about coding, it all comes from me just having these guys on Teams.
Yeah.
And wonderful team of engineers to go after.
Yeah. So definitely, we are an open book. And like I said, we are going to be hanging out after in the hallway. So please come ask us questions. Please make sure you pop them in the Pubble, and we can see those after. I think we can like export it. So we'll try and address whatever we miss, maybe with a blog. We want to do a birthday blog for MAUI. I think that would be fun. So also, if you want to do the Microsoft Learn course, it's right there. Very cool. Thank you, everybody. I hope you had a great build. And it has been so great to see you. Thanks.